But you look so comfortable up there, it seems a shame to disturb you. Huh, and what about that extension you promised to build on the nest? It is going to be very cramped when the little ones arrive. Especially that big one in the clutch. Goodness knows what size of that chick it's going to be. You know, I reckon that might be a turkey's egg. Okay, Drake, how could a turkey's egg get to be in my nest? Must be your side of the family.
We'll just have to wait and see who she takes after, won't we, dear?
Yes, dear.
Anyway, must fly. I promised the rooster that I'd help him count his chickens. Shall I see you back here?
Well, where else?
try to find him for me? He's probably making a wave down in the local watering hole.
All right. Auntie Mormor's off now. I'll see you later.
Auntie Mormor, what are we
doing? What are we brewing?
Yeah, we're out.
I was getting scrambled inside that egg.
No, don't go thinking this is the whole world. It stretches far beyond the other side of the lake, right into the churchyard. Number two, you must feather your own nest every morning. Number three, no looking up to sunset. Number four, no point in between meals. And number... Wait a minute. You aren't all here.
Hey, guys, there's going to be another nest of the day.
Oh, quack.
Happy ever, won't I be mine?
sudden moves.
What are you quacking about?
There's something behind you. Something not very nice.
Oh, this is your daughter, dear.
Ah, created a monster.
Don't be ridiculous. She's just not your normal run-of-the-mill kind of duck. That's all. She didn't even manly, but alas, he became crispy and aromatic before his time. Still, life goes on.
Now, I understand Maureen for the children from the farmhouse throwing bread to the water.
Ta-ra! You have to try it. It's much better than the usual stuff. Even the crusts are nice.
Oh, yes, Maureen. It's delicious. Come along, children, try this.
Make way for the red banded duck.
I know, we really are going to have to do something about that, huh?
Well, look, the sun!
Make your egg go red.
But that's not fair!
she gone?
I thought she was with you.
She was. Just a moment ago.
Well, if she's got any sense, she'll probably have gone to find a dad to put over her head.
Drink! That's enough!
Calm down, love. She's probably just wandered back to the lake. You know how she loves swimming.
No, without telling me she wouldn't. Where's she gone?
Oh, for goodness sake.
All right, Turkey, you go that way and look along by the milking ship. Maureen and Henrietta, check around the house. We'll take the ducklings down to the lake.
Oh. father went missing. How are you bearing up? Can you manage to cheer for the camera?
What? This is Jaber from America's Most Feathered. They're doing a feature. Now I share you with my best side.
Aya, there have been rumors of farmyard bullying. Do you believe that your daughter was abducted, or is it possible that she ran away to escape her persecutors?
What are you saying?
That's good. I'll buy that. Defensive yet emotional. Just a hint of anger. I'm filling up here.
What about me? Does no one care about what I think?
Sorry, sir. Coming to the end of transmission. I'm going to leave the final word with Ida just in case her daughter is out there watching. But for now, this is Jay Bird for America's Most Feathered, saying that if you see anything suspicious, from thieving magpies to lost ducklings, the chicks on the switchboard are ready to take your call. All right, Ida, it's all yours.
Way.
Where were you trying to get to?
Back to my mother, on the lake. I think it must be in that direction. I'll ask some probably their last flying mission.
What do you mean?
There's a shoot on the marsh here. It's very dangerous.
What is a shoot?
Well, it's a people sport. One group of men moves through the marsh here and ducks into the air, while a second group with guns and shoots them back out of the air again.
The cat warned me about people.
The cat?
Well, yes, you see, I'm often his cat.
Didn't your mother tell you how dangerous the cat is?
Oh, yes, she did.
But the cat says she's my friend.
You don't want friends like that, dear. Your mother was right to warn you.
She was.
Gun dogs. They may be starting to shoot again. Time for maneuvers. I hadn't hoped it would come to this, but I have no other option. All right, at ease. Company, fall in. I didn't mean literally. All right, eyes front. Now we are about to take part in an exercise, the likes of which we have not faced before. Our task is one of reconnaissance and reunification.
This duckling's lost her mom, but left her, and we're going to find her.
You are a fine-bodied geese, and I know you will give your best. Good luck, men.
Come with us.
Oh, cat.
Our wings are spread.
relieved at the time, has what can be best described as a rather unforgettable appearance. Now, our experts believe that she may have already undergone certain changes, and they have put together a composite of what she might look like today. Some viewers may find this image disturbing.
Ida, if you see this look, come home. The kids need you. They're not coping so well without you.
In a sinister moment, it would appear that Ida has now also gone missing. So once again, viewers, we are appealing to you if you have any information. The number is coming up on your screen.
As strong as the others, I'll stay back with you and fly at your pace.
So, my-
must keep going. I have to find my mother. I'm sure she can't be far away. But when you return in the spring, we can meet up again.
I like that. Are you sure you'll be all right?
I'm sure.
Hey, come along, darling. You'll be late.
I really don't like to leave you like this, but I must go now. Thank you again. I won't forget you.
Classic.
for one last time.
Ew,
well, you can't have it both ways. Quick, make up your mind.
I'll break your mind.
And don't try any funny noises. Remember, at least this way, you can see your mother again.
Going! It must be
been strong enough.
Well, now you can come with us and learn our way.
And my mother, can she come too?
Oh, of course I can't. Just a bad young duck. I can't teach you the ways of the swan,
but you taught me to swim.
And from what I remember, that nearly finished me off. Hardly surprising, really. Fancy me teaching a swan to swim.
But I want you to come.
I can't come with you. My place is back on the lake with your father, bless him.
Thinking about.
Wait a minute. I've got a little unfinished business.